Here we go, baby. Yes, sir. This is exactly what I'm talking about, you guys. Hey, what's good, you guys? How you guys doing today, man? Hope your day is going great. And if you're not watching this video, we'll make things 10 times better, baby. We are back at it again with another video. And as you guys can see right behind me, man, I've been holding this secret back from you guys for a while now. Actually, the intro that you guys saw to this video was probably filmed, I'll say probably a year ago. A whole entire year ago, you guys. That intro was filmed. I don't know exactly why it took me so long. There it is. That's my new car right back there. Going around the corner. I don't know why it took me this long, you know, to announce this to you guys, but I have this, bro. I have a 5th gen 2010 SS Camaro, man, right here in my hands. Now, a little backstory with this car. My OG viewers, you guys know that I've had this car like for a while now. It's been in my pop's hands for the longest. You know, I actually decided to take it off of his hands from him. He was looking to sell this car and just flat out get rid of it. And I was like, whoa, my bro. Calm down a little bit, slow your roll. Let me take control of this, let me have it, let me do what I wanna do to this car. And bam, here it is, you guys. So, like I said, we got this 5th gen 2010 SS Camaro, super, super clean. Now, we actually bought this car here, you know, straight off the dealership floor, brand new, no miles on it. In 2010, that's when he first purchased this vehicle, and we've had it ever since. Now, over the years, we have taken great care of it. And actually, if you get in on the inside, you know, it still has, got the music going, but it still has like, it still has the new car smell. Believe it or not, it really does have the new car smell. I don't know what that smell is, like if it's like the leather or something. I don't know. If you guys know the new car smell, you know what I'm talking about. You know, like I said, we've just, you know, really taken care of this car. You know, it's not really that many, you know, incorrections on the paint itself. You guys, I mean, we're looking at it here in the sun, and this paint looks spectacular, you guys. I mean, there's some small things like this, you know, going around the sides, but we're not going to point out the imperfections here on this car. I guess this is the adhesive coming from up under the wing on the rear. But you guys know that comes with a 10-year-old, almost 13-year-old. Well, actually, this is, in just a few days, and probably the next 30 days, this will be a 13-year-old car. So, of course, it's going to have its little imperfections. Of course, like the sun fade on the front grille here and on the bottom down there and down here. So, you know, that plastics, that's just normal wear and tear for a 13-year-old car. I am beyond excited and stoked to, you know, to introduce this car to you guys, to reveal it, you know, to finally share it with you guys. I honestly don't even know why I have been, you know, just scared. I think that's the word. I've been scared, you know, to really just jump into this car scene, because you guys know everything that you pretty much get into is going to be a money pit, no matter what it is. So I think that's probably one of the biggest reasons I was scared to really just jump right into this, because once you guys jump into a project that you know that you want to build on, you're going to constantly just dump money and money and money into it. So that was like my biggest fear. I don't like spending money. I do not like spending money. I'm gonna say it flat out. I do not like spending money. Like, I like money, don't get me wrong, but I don't like spending it. Now that I'm actually telling you guys are gonna see more and more content on this car. And I mean, I have no problem with that, but I just gotta make it happen. That's the only issue. I just gotta make it happen, man. We gotta get some more content coming for you guys. Car content at that.
There we go.
So you guys already know we had to go with the manual, the 6-speed manual transmission SS Camaro. There's no other way to go. If we gotta get a sports car, we gonna do things right. You feel me? If we gonna get a sports car, we gotta do things right. We can't automatic get out of here, bro. See if I can do this one-handed. There we go. All right. Now, it's a V8. Come on now. It's a V8. We got that LS in this bad boy. You guys know, we're coming strong, man. This motor is something serious. This is the big dog right here. Obviously, straight off the rip, Jesus, needs cleaning really, really bad. We did install a cold air intake. So this has actually been on the car pretty long. But that's the only modification to this car that has been done. That is the only downside, you know, to this vehicle. This car is 100% bone stock. Other than the cold air intake, this car is 100% bone stock. That is the only downside to this car. Now, I wouldn't say that is a complete downside, because that will give me the full opportunity to build this car out the way that I want it. So it being, you know, completely stock, I have thousands and thousands of options to choose from when it comes to modifying this car. Maybe not thousands, but hundreds. We have plenty of options to choose from. I've been running this plan over and over and over in my head, so I have an actual set plan for this car, and I think it's gonna turn out pretty sick. You know, I know some people, all right? I know some people, and you know, I just want to work with these companies, work with these teams to help get the job done. The stock exhaust doesn't sound terrible. It's decent, but it doesn't meet the requirements or the standards of YBD. That's probably going to be one of the first things that we switch up, you feel me? So we got to get rid of that stock exhaust. We got to get some noise flowing from this baby. And yeah, man, we just got to make it happen. I mean, even the stitching on the seat, you guys, still in perfect condition. The SS emblem right there on the seat. Not anything to complain about. The dashboard, we got everything. Everything's pretty much stock, clean, excellent condition. Oh my gosh, I'm in love. Like, I've been in love with this car for the longest. You know, growing up as a kid, nobody, and I mean nobody, was really allowed to drive this car, except for my dad. But today's the day where things are changing, you guys. I'm 20 years old, you know, buying my first sports car, SS Camaro. We just got more to come. You know, this is the start. This is the beginning of something major. And I'm excited to, you know, to start that journey. Climb aboard, my boy. Get your book bag. You gonna leave your book bag outside? What up?
What's up? Where are you taking us?
We finna go for a little ride, my boy.
Oh yeah, where to?
I don't know. But we finna go for a ride. We're gonna do a couple runs on this road real quick. I really want to do this because I just want to show that you can't really hear the exhaust like you're supposed to hear it through the car, like you're supposed to. But we're going to do a quick little pull real quick. Yeah, we gotta do something about the exhaust for sure, man. So another main reason that I really want to do something to the exhaust, I just don't know what I want to do exactly just yet. But you guys can hear very slightly when I like downshift a little bit, or when I just coast from like third, sometimes fourth, or even second. You can hear it backfire a little bit, and I want those pops to really be defined and, you know, make it sound like we busting caps around here. You know what I'm saying? Let's go, baby! No, like I told you guys earlier, one of the best parts about having a sports car is definitely having it in manual. And I think that just kind of adds to the fun. It just makes everything 10 times better, in my opinion. You know, you get to just throw gears.
You gotta teach me how to drive stick.
You wanna learn how to drive stick?
Yes.
See, it didn't do it that time when I downshifted in a second. But yeah, man, we're gonna have some fun with this car. I just want to let y'all know that right now. We can try this road right here. I already know this road. I forgot about this. What the hell, bro?
I heard a little bit.
Hold on. There we go.
Yeah.
You guys didn't hear it anyway, so. Nah, y'all won't be able to hear it. But no, that is, like I said, man, we gotta make that happen, because we wanna be here. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Yeah.
Hurry up.
Unlock the doors. Ain't gonna lie, that pull off is slow.
Slow?
Yeah, hold on to a minute.
I wasn't trying to go fast. Yeah, we been, could have started, but it's never late. Do it for my kids, kids, yeah, let's set it straight. Do it for your kids, kids, gotta set it straight. It's time to regulate. We need change now. We need solo, we need Evie in the game now. Make it change so the earth we know can stay around. Make it change cause we had no time for playing around. Let's quit the playing around. First rule to me. First modification, somewhat done. If you guys want to call this a little a mod or whatever you want to call it. But we had to stop by this morning, get the windows tinted. I mean, this just makes the car look 10 times better overall. Doing this thing for real, like I told you guys, you know, we had to start with this. If we just step back from it a little bit, it makes the car just pop even more. We no longer rocking the fishbowl look, so. Dude, I always hated driving around this car, and then I, like any car at that, you know, you look over at somebody or people can look in at you, and I'm like, stop looking at me. But nah, you can't see nothing now. We got 5%. All around, except on the windshield, we got I think this is 20 on the front, and then the sizing in the back, we got 5. Even the back, you know, we got it blacked out, looks absolutely amazing. I think it turned out great. Let's get a little inside look. It's still daylight outside, so now we don't have. I know earlier, he can't even. Can you see me? Can you see me?
No,
he can't even see me. So, I know earlier in the video when I had a GoPro set up, you guys could see the little flares going in and out the window from the sun. But now with this tint, you guys are no longer gonna get, you know, majority of those flares coming in through the windshield or the side window. So that is a plus. This is how it looks from the inside. It is, I don't know what, 2 o'clock right now. The sun is still out beaming and everything. We got a little bit of overcast, but you guys kind of get the point. I think the tint looks amazing. That's done and done, baby. First of many, you guys. First of many. So you guys just stay prepared for more to come. What you think's next, my boy? What you think's next? What we gotta do next?
I would say some rims.
Some rims, some wheels?
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, it is kind of throwing it off a little bit, but ain't nothing too bad.
But if not, I'll probably say an engine mod.
Engine?
Engine mod.
Yeah. Exhaust.
Exhaust, yeah.
Exhaust,
that's
baby.
What, that's what you gotta do.
Yeah.
Well, I'll probably wait, because to see what engine mod you're gonna do then.
Nah, we'll just do all the tuning and everything later.
Yeah. I'll see y'all later. White gold, keep the lace gold chain, keep the beast inside and the hoes inside. Yeah. Like a mirror jeans in a Lambo truck with 2 powder bags and a ball made phrase. I'll have in the game plus 1 message, cause you know YV gotta get that.